I'm Dave, and this is Austin Eats. I love pizza, and in fact, I love pizza so much that I built a wood-burning oven in my backyard. I'm gonna make a pizza today that I've never done before. It's gonna be a deep dish style pizza cooked in a cast iron skillet, and I'm gonna do it inside the wood-burning oven. Let's get cooking.
I'm using the Caputo brand chef flour for this pizza. I don't need the pizzeria flour because I'm not cooking at 900 degrees. All-purpose flour would work as well. You can find the recipe for the pizza dough in the comments below. Let's get it mixed up. Now that the dough is done, I'm going to stretch it left to right, fold it over itself, and then top to bottom and over itself again. And I'm going to just pull it back and form it into a bowl and just make it nice and tight. And then in the dough tub it goes for a 4-hour rest. After 4 hours, it's looking good, ready to go. Let's make some pizza. So first I'm going to brush the inside of a cast iron skillet, a 12-inch skillet, generously with olive oil. Then I'm going to place my dough in there. I'm going to spread it out the best that I can, but honestly, it's really sticky and it just doesn't move very well. So I'm going to cover it with some olive oil, and that's going to help the process a bit. I'm going to push it out to the best of my ability, and then I'm going to let it just sit for about 10 minutes. 10 minutes later, I can push it all the way to the edges with no problem. That's looking pretty darn good. I'm using San Marzano Roma tomatoes from Italy. Put these in a blender with a little kosher salt, and that's my sauce. Add about a third a cup, spread it all over, almost to the edge, and then this needs to see some oven time. Now, the fire's ready to go. Push these logs back and par-bake the crust. It's important to bake the crust part way before I add the sauce and the cheese. Why? Because this thing is so thick, it'll be soggy if I didn't do this. So it's going to go in for about 7 or 8 minutes. I'm rotating it quite a bit. By the way, you can do this whole thing in the oven at 550 degrees, but it's a lot more fun doing this with fire. Now that it's par-baked, I'm going to add more sauce to the top, spread that all around, and now it is time for some cheese. And I'm using, on this pizza, simply mozzarella and a little Asiago and some Fontina. Spread that all around, and then, well, I like more cheese than that. Let's really lay this on, because this is a thick pizza. It needs a lot of cheese. So now it's time for pepperoni. Now, I'm a big pepperoni guy. Let's lay it on nice and thick. I mean, really thick. I mean, I don't want to see the top thick. Oh, that's looking really good. Okay, we're almost done. And I think it's time to show this thing some fire. So this pizza came out perfectly. It popped right out of the pan. It was easy to cut, and all of that oil in the pan just sort of almost fried the bottom of the crust. It is so good. This truly is one of the best pizzas I've ever made. No joke. Hey, if you liked the video, let me know and please subscribe. We've got new videos coming out every week. Thanks for watching. See you next time on Austin Eats.